Welcome to Santa Apostolic Mayen, which means Malian Apostolic Center. We're here in Bamako, the capital city of Mali, which is right now the 10th poorest nation in the world. I invite you to come in and see our center and see what God is doing in this nation. The government gave this property to us for free a few years ago because we're a Christian group who did not have property yet. In 2007, we started building the water tower. But water is necessary to build. We actually built the water on the property. And then our first house that we all lived in, you can see, in the middle between the two other houses right now. After completing the first house we all live in right now, we started building the dining hall that you can see right now. We have two rooms on the top where some of our workers are sleeping and living. Now this big empty space at the other half of our property will be the location for our three-story building. For the church, the medical center, our school, as well as dorms for 200 people. This has been our kitchen since we moved here 3 years ago. However, when it's rainy season, this area of our property is flooded, and so we needed to find a solution.
And this is the solution. In February of 2011, we finished laying the outdoor tiles in the area between the first two finished buildings. This is now a permanent kitchen and allows our cooks, here Elizabeth and Fanta, take the food straight into the adjacent dining hall. We feed not only the 18 people living on our base, but also a good number of non-resident children whose families are too poor to take care of. The street children sleeping at our base every night also receive 2 meals a day.
This is the first house we built. It only took a couple of months to finish. We moved in here in February 2008, before the house was actually finished. We had no windows, we had no doors, and no bathroom or kitchen. But let's go see what's inside this house. This is the living room. It's actually the children's living room.
Und dies sind die 13 Kinder, die bei uns leben. Die meisten von ihnen frühere Straßenkinder.
My name is Adama. I'm 18.
My name is Joseph. I'm 18.
My name is Florante. I'm 15.
My name is Karim. I am 14.
My name is Jeremy. I'm 14.
My name is Tara. I'm 11.
My name's Amadou, I'm 11.
My name's Hannah, I'm 9.
My name's Boubacar, I'm 8.
My name's Bakan, I'm 7.
My name's Sarata, I'm 5.
What's your name?
Renata.
How old are you? 2.
Dies sind unsere 17 externen Kinder, die von uns Essen, medizinische Versorgung und Schulgeld bekommen und die auch viel Spaß auf unserem Zentrum haben. Eine Kinderpatenschaft beträgt 40 Euro pro Monat.
As you can see, the TV set for DVDs. This thing here is for putting all the money, pocket money and precious things inside. And we have 2 bedrooms to view from this living room, as well as one of our guest rooms. It is also the place where our computer is located. That's the computer the children and workers are allowed to use.
Every child has an email address to stay in touch with their sponsors.
Now this is where the older children sleep. As you can tell, they're all boys. If you look really closely, it's a mess.
Now this is the younger children's room. As you can see, there's room for three bunk beds instead of just two. And it's a mess as well.
Besides DVDs, we have many games for the children to play. From Duplo to Lego to puzzles, memory, and of course the ever-present soccer. Here, the older kids are playing their favorite game.
Leaving the children's living room, we're now going into my kitchen. Right now this is my kitchen, but once filling is finished, then our ladies will have this kitchen at their disposal. Especially in rainy season, it will be really helpful. The door in our children's living room contains a lot of information. From the Bible passages they have to read that day, to the daily tasks that rotate every week. Calendar so they know what to do at what time. And of course, with that many people, we need to be able to not forget whose birthday it is so that we can have a nice birthday celebration with cake and fun. Now we're leaving the first building and I will take you to our dining hall. Hi, Mavia. Now this is our dining hall. This place is used for many different things. Every night the street children sleep here and spend the night here.
What market is this?
Simon.
Oh, Simon. Ami, what market, André?
So, ils sont en train de jeter. Je vais vous donner un autre travail. Je ferai de vous des pêcheurs
d'hommes. Nevena, how can money
o senhor
é desperfilê. O senhor é inverno, nunca isso.
We have another room where our team members sleep. Actually, this is the last time you will see the area here like this, because we're getting ready to build another bathroom, kitchen, a living room, and a bedroom here for the family who's going to join us in May of 2011. We're in the district of Yirimadio. This is a new part of town, and as you can see, people are building everywhere. Just a few years ago, there was nothing out here. But this city is growing for 200,000 people a year. To the north of our base, we have this beautiful little hill. However, it's also the location of many sacrifices of chickens, other animals, and even children. We go out into our neighborhood from time to time to evangelize and invite people to special events. And not everybody likes us, but still, we see people come, and we see people come to faith as well as being healed. Now you can see our first building again. This is the roof of our first building, and what you see there is the backside of our solar panels. As this part of town is still new, there is no electricity, no water supply, and no telephone lines. So we depend on our solar panels for electricity, as well as our water tower for water. Right now we have three vehicles, and we built some shade for them recently. We have two pickup trucks that work some of the time, but we have to repair them quite frequently. And in the summer of 2010, we were so blessed to be able to buy this little bus seat. However, what we did not know is that you don't only need a truck license to be allowed to drive that bus, but also a public transportation license to transport people with it. And so our children are back on the back of a big pickup truck, in danger of falling off as we transport them to school. Now I want to show you the most important location on a Malian toilet. From the location of a Malian toilet, we have a very good view of all that's been built so far. From the dining hall to the very left, the main first building we built that we all live in right now, to a construction site, our third building that we hope to finish within the next few months. This building is going to be the place for me to live in, as well as for our visitors. And look at the interior of the building we're building right now. We're now in the living room of the building that is under construction right now. However, by the time you watch this, I hope that this will look very different. Painted with tiles and furniture. So why don't you come visit us in Mali? And you can be in our guest room right in this building. I could not do this work if it wasn't for my faithful team. This is Paul, my 22-year-old assistant, who is my local leader and pastor of my three churches. Then there's Christian, an Austrian volunteer, who is here with us for 1 year. Finally, we have Adama, who is our day guard.
And Dami, who is our night guard.
Then there is Salim, who is our driver, one of our kids that is all grown up. And finally, two of our three ladies that cook for us every day, Fanta as well as Rosalie.
And Elizabeth, Paul's stepmom, who completes our faithful ladies in the kitchen. Ich hoffe, euch hat der Besuch unseres Zentrums in Bamako gefallen. Für mehr Informationen, Blogs und Bilder geht bitte zu meiner Website. Und so verlasse ich euch mit einer malischen Segnung. Alakaduba Oye.